guys, what's up? It's C-Bot here, and today I'm going to teach you how to upgrade your town hall to the next level fast and efficiently in Clash of Clans. So this is going to be a really easy tutorial for you guys to follow, and it's not necessarily the 100% fastest way to upgrade your town hall, but it's the most beneficial and efficient way to do it. So let's go ahead and get started with the tips. The very first tip is to upgrade every building to max before upgrading the town hall. So you're going to need to follow most of these steps before to upgrade your town hall. So if you're a Town Hall 9 and you want to upgrade to Town Hall 10 just because there's Inferno Towers at Town Hall 10, that's not a very good idea. You never want to rush your Town Hall to the next level just because of a defensive item that you might be able to unlock at the next level. So it happens to be that I see a lot of Town Hall 10s with level 1 defenses, let's say in Masters League or around Gold League, and I really don't want that to happen to you guys. I want you guys to be the strongest Town Halls out there so you can have some strong defenses, strong buildings before you go to the next level. So now let's get into the second tip, and that's have 5 Builder's Hut work on different buildings at the same time. So this is 100% very important. Unlock those Builder's Huts. If you have gems, go ahead, use those gems to get the builder huts. I know that a lot of people don't want to spend money on the game, but if you save up your gems, don't waste it on stupid things like speeding up, let's say, like a collector or something like that. Do not speed up your buildings. Use them for gems. So I believe the first builder set is 250 gems, the second one is 500 gems, and they keep on getting higher and higher. So if you consistently keep on removing some shrubbery or some trunks, getting those gem boxes, I'm sure that you'll be able to save up enough gems to get those builder sets fast, legitimately, and without spending any of your real money on Clash of Clans. So as you can see, I'm upgrading a building right now to max level, and that's just like an example of what you guys need to do before upgrading to the next town hall. So obviously I'm not the best example on this. My barracks could have been upgraded to level 10 at Town Hall 8, but I just didn't want to. I didn't want to upgrade P.E.K.K.A.s that early. So now this brings me to my next tip, and this is going to be having a good farming army composition. Now having a good farming army composition and fighting regularly or attacking regularly with this troop composition is very important to actually upgrading your troops and upgrading your buildings in order to upgrade your Town Hall in the end. So of course all of these things bring out to Town Hall 10 at the end. That's the big major end goal. So you can see he's farming. This guy that's particularly farming in Daddy's Darlings, do not know his name or how to pronounce it, but he's farming with Barbarians, Archers, Wallbreakers, his Clan Castle, Barbarian King, Archer Queen. He's got 4 lightning spells and 1 poison spell. So that's a pretty interesting strategy. He found a lot of gold in Silver 1, gold and elixir. So this is a really interesting tip. You always want to be on the lookout for loot-filled bases in Silver 1, Gold 1, and around that area. So if you're a Town Hall 7, Town Hall 8, this is mostly for you guys, or Town Hall 6, you want to look for loot around there. Usually Barbarians or Archers, but you can find your own farming composition yourself. You can look up farming army composition updated in YouTube, and you'll find a ton of them. But this is the most beneficial for me. So 20 seconds remaining on this raid, he's taken 300,000 gold, 255,000 elixir with 1,920 dark elixir. You can see 48% on the base. Obviously, it's not necessary for you to get the 1-star, but if you want to go for trophies, then you can go ahead and do it. He's going to drop in his Archer Queen at the top of the base, along with Barbarian King, to pick off that extra collector. Get that loot, 405,000 elixir. Big props to him with 10 trophies. So now let's get into the next tip. We were just talking about farming, so let's talk about putting your town hall on the outside. So putting your town hall on the outside basically protects your loot in the center of the base. This means dark elixir, gold, and elixir. You want to save up your gold and elixir to upgrade these max buildings before you upgrade your town hall. I know you guys want to upgrade your town hall very, very fast, but you're going to need to upgrade these buildings first, and saving up gold and elixir and dark elixir for you to do that will be more beneficial and will stop attackers from gaining some of this loot. And I know a lot of you guys want to protect your loot, so put town hall on the outside. They'll take the town hall most likely, and then they'll leave. They won't take the loot, which is in the center of the base. So the very last tip is to upgrade your heroes, and while you're upgrading a lot of these buildings, you also want to focus on the troop aspect of things. You'll have the Barbarian King unlocked most likely if you're a Town Hall 7 and above, so you want to keep upgrading him along with some of these buildings to get more loot on your raids and to be able to upgrade your Town Hall in the end, which is the big major goal. So that wraps up the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Tell me what you guys think in the comment section down below. If you guys want free gems to maybe unlock your builder's hut, go ahead and click the first link down in the description. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. On the rail, homie, on the rail. Tell me how you feel. Everything I spit is gold, like I got a grill. Bet you